So, Captain Jack, everything okay?
Absolutely. Everything is great.
He's my Jack Sparrow. Jack
Sparrow. Hi, mateys.
I'll make you famous.
Yeah. Yeah, you did. My kids loved the video.
They loved it.
Yeah, great. Yeah.
They will get a chance to see another one today.
This vessel that is coming is the Marine Police. Let's give some trust to go slowly, slowly to see the sail left. Okay. I will be lowering the halyard and you will be pulling the reef line. So I'm lowering the halyard and you are pulling the reef line. Now we have reefed the button mainsail. So prepare the starboard jib sheet to pull it, to pull the Genoa. Let's go.
Ελεύθερα από την Νίνο μου, διέννε.
Let's go. Alright, you can use the winch hand if the lazy gypsy is below a hatch. When you do a tug, you start pulling. This hatch, you can make a big damage.
Okay.
So this is something we should always keep an eye. Okay. Bravo, Nebby. Lovely, Nebby. Your Genoa is quite big,
Yes, okay. 140%.
That's lovely there. You see that? Chrysos Genoa is so big.
Yes.
If you bring the car there, the traveler on, how we know if it's right? If I see on the sail on the Genoa some horizontal bends like this, it means that the halyard needs to be tightened a bit. Okay. If I see some vertical bends on the Genoa, it means that the halyard is over tightened. That's why it makes this vertical bends. Whereas if I see the horizontal bends, it means it needs a little bit more rise. Now, if it's windy, when it's windy, you need to tighten the halyard. Γιατί ανασφαλίσεις δεν μπορείς να τραβήσεις. Θέλεις 2 με 3 γύρους. How we are going to do the tug?
I'll get ready to release this, but keep a hand on it.
Correct.
And then is when the Genoa starts.
Basically, you do like this. You take the load.
Yeah.
Okay. It's like this. Okay. You take the load. You undo it. You untail it, and you hold it here.
Yeah.
And when the sail backwinds, then you release, and as you release, you take out the remaining turns as well. Okay, so get ready. Let's tag. Bravo. Okay, now release, fully release, baby. Fully release, bravo. Bravo. Okay. Ωραία.
Release more, Debbie, release more.
And the rest of the area. And now you can head to 40, let's go close hold. Let's go on a close hold point of sail. You see that this is a big sail and also it is cut down. So it's a lot of sail area on this.
Collects all the wind.
On Alexander, Sauer and Genoa is not that. I have a very big Genoa, Mr. Chris.
This is 45, 46 meters almost.
It's a very big Genoa. Okay, let's go out of his way. How we can go out of his way? Shall we do a jibe? Let's attempt to do a jibe. Prepare to pull. Dino, prepare to release. And I'm bringing the main sailing vessel. So we're doing it in a control manner as we have discussed again. So start turning. Start turning. Bravo. Ωραία. Now, bravo. Περίμενε να φτιάξει άρα μου πίσω ο Ιντίνο μου. Τώρα θα πρέπει start fully. Χαλάρωσε ρε.
Χαλάρωσε δεν γιαντίνο.
Μπράβο guys. Okay, make it straight here. Make it straight here, Jack. Because we are going to keep an open point of sail. So, you see the important thing on the jibe is to bring the boom in the middle and to release it once the stern is through the wind.
Right.
It was coming a lot of spray, so she was becoming full sweat, by the time we finished. So we bring some food. I will also arrange to bring them barbecue. We put it at the stern and we go, we anchor to move them boat like this. You need to be very careful because it's an open point of sail, okay? And there is a risk for an accidental jibe.
Yeah.
You have the wind at 118 degrees. Don't look at the instrument, it needs calibration. What it shows the instrument, Chris? Let's try to do it again. Turn a little bit to the right. Turn a little bit to the right. All right. Little bit more to the right.
Yeah, I'm losing my Genoa.
Little bit more to the right. Little bit more, just a little bit more.
Really
keep it there, Put one something
on the horizon.
On land to help you go straight.
Yeah.
And Chriso check the instrument and tell us what it shows. What it shows this.
I will photo it. It's almost 180, eh?
180?
176.
Not too bad. Okay. Ideally, on this wing-on-wing sailing, we can put... And we can also put a preventer to keep the boom from jibing accidentally. But you see, I have the jib sheet in my hand. If I see it coming, I will pull, so I reduce the swing.
Yes.
Complete the jibe. How we are going to complete the jibe?
Okay, if she's going to complete the jibe from this way, then this will be lazy.
You release. To,
yeah, okay. You're already.
Okay, it is already in the release, Jack.
Okay,
release now. Bravo. Okay, and then keep it there. Keep it there. This is it. And because we are on an open point of sail, those fixes. You don't need to tie any too. So now you are going, you are more or less on a broad ridge.
Yes.
Okay, you are more or less on a broad ridge. What it shows the instrument, how many degrees?
Yeah, about 145.
145, it may be 130 if it needs a little bit of calibration, but we are more or less there. So you saw that. Moving, if you are on wing on wing and you want to complete the jibe, just one sail you need to move.
Yeah, true. The other
in
one's
this
already
case,
there.
We moved the Genoa. It could have been if we turn this way, we are going to move the mainsail. We are going to use a little bit this traveler here. So you see how this traveler works. Let's head up a little bit more. So we get some wind. Okay, let's head up a little bit. Okay. When we head up, what do we do with the sails?
Tighten them in.
Tighten them in. Shift them in. Correct. Okay. So, gallop. And gallop. Dora, I want you to show you what I can do here. Here I can. I can bring this here. Okay, why I should do this? What it helps me. Okay, I can either have it in the middle, okay, and release the sheet, or I can release the traveler to go there. Okay. Try to head up a little bit further. Try to head up because this is more important when you are going to blow spot. And I will show you where it happens. Head up to go blow spot, around 40 or 50 degrees. Okay. Τώρα αντίνο μου λίγο να χρειαστείς να σφίξεις που πάμε σε άλλο πάνω. Try to go close. Okay. If it's very light, the wind condition, okay, I can bring this windward, the traveler, so I keep this exactly in the center. I can have this in the center. Okay, I can have it in the center and just release a little bit my sheet. If I release my sheet, the sail will open, but at the same time you will see that the boom will go into that sheet. See, you see the boom going up? So I'm opening and it's going up. By going up, it also gives some twist to the leech. What I could do is keep this tight and I can change the angle of attack of the wind by doing this. Now the shape of the sail is the same, but we change the angle of attack without changing the shape of the sail. So this is the use of the traveler.
Because the traveler now isn't pulling at such a steep angle.
Say for example, the wind conditions are light. Okay, are light. And I want to keep my sail full. Okay. Instead of releasing the main ship, okay, and to lose the in depth, yeah, in the sail, I can do it with the top.
Yeah.
I can do it with the top. As we discussed, for the cruising sailor, that's really bother with this. It's because, you see, it's a very small traveler. I mean, I just can't. We really want, we are here, we are in distress, the engine does the start, the mechanic we have.
He's lazy.
How to fix it, he's lazy. So we want to go with the sails to the marina.
Okay, so I'm wondering, do we want to pass in front of that ship or behind that
you
ship?
You decide. One
way or another, we have a jibe in our future. Yeah. That's good.
To go towards the cranes, we are going to turn like this.
Yeah. And so
the wind is from this direction. So we are going to do a jibe.
We're going to do a jibe.
So let's do a jibe and see and try to go towards the cranes and we see what to do.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes.
And, when she initiates,
yes,
then we're gonna have this loose.
Yes.
And as soon as it starts fluttering,
yes,
then I'm gonna haul in.
Let's do it. Okay, you turn towards the crane. Bravo. Pull whatever is coming, Jack. Pull whatever is coming. Now pull it. Just remember. Bravo. Okay. And because it is a wide point of sail,
there you
don't really need to tighten it up much. We are again on a broad reach. Okay. So let's go this way. We are heading towards the marina. This way. And once we pass the ship, we head up a little bit and this will bring us straight to the entrance of the marina. Jack, can you pull a little bit the red and gray reef line, please? Yeah. Whatever is coming, pull it.
This shot will take you straight to Hollywood.
Silicone spray will do. It keeps them, alive. Καλό όπου θέλεις να το δούμε.
38.
Ακριβώς.
Και είναι μπαλουσάσεις. Βασεβάρκες, δηλαδή. You don't have the engine and you can go to the harbor with the sails. Yeah. This is very important. Ναι, βάλω ούλον το σώμα. Να είναι το βάρος του σώματος, ας το πούμε.
Ναι, μπράβο.
Okay, lovely. And now secure it. Jack, secure it.
Put into gear.
We want to pull this bank.
Now it's in gear.
Okay. Are they ready?
Alright. How are we gonna solve it? Debbie will go in the wheel.
Okay.
Slowly, slowly you go in the wheel. This, again, as we did earlier, I will bring in the middle, but I don't want to bring it in the middle and make it
tight,
as strong as I can, because this doesn't give this little leverage for the sail to lap. You see, very easy to lap. Whereas if I come little to the right, David, to the right, you want maybe you stand up, if you can see through down, Jack, slowly, slowly. As he is slowly, more slowly, Jack, come down, we go around no more. One to the left, one to the right. Come down, Jack, bravo. Okay, come down. Bravo. Parche da scignà mesa antino mujamiane si scignà pute smoothes. All right. So, ιδανικά τι νόμου θέλουμε, μπαίνουμε μαζί, μια αριστερά, μια δεξιά, καταλαβαίνεις. Για να μπει έναν περίπου, όπως το διπλώνουμε για να το φυλάξουμε το σιμόν. Okay, now it's a very small triangle left, so you can give me at a higher pace. Μπράβο, ακριβώς έτσι. Μια δεξιά, μια αριστερά. Release a little bit more halyard.
Yes, please. Released.
All right.
Before he was working with the jet engines, he was on a pirate ship.
Uh-huh. In a previous life.
And we are closing the bar.
And he had a big ship with about 200 crew. All professional pirates.
All highly trained.
Highly trained.